all know and love the International Space Station, but NASA designed some space stations in the 60s, 70s, and 80s that never got off the ground, and we can discover them through concept art. So that's what we're going to do today on Vintage Space. Some of the earliest ever designs for space stations focused on a torus or donut-shaped station. The idea was that by spinning the station, there would be enough gravity at the edges of the donut for people to walk upright like they would on Earth. This low artificial gravity environment was thought to be an excellent way to extend man's capability in working and living in space. And so we see a lot of these donut-style spacecraft in the early space station concepts. The torus shape was pioneered by Hermann Nordung in 1928 when he published a blueprint for this type of space station, and it's more familiar to us now as the type of space station seen in the movie 2001: A Space Odyssey. But the torus wasn't just fodder for science fiction. In the early 1960s, NASA did look into building a donut-shaped inflatable space station, but it never got off the ground, in large part because the agency was laser-focused on getting a man to the moon by the end of the 1960s, and when the last three Apollo missions were canceled, it left the agency with excess hardware. As we know, that hardware went in large part to the Skylab program, NASA's first ever proof of concept space station program. It used a repurposed S-4B upper stage launched on a Saturn V to become the first ever orbiting space station for American astronauts. Skylab was NASA's only successful use of excess Apollo hardware for a true space station, but it wasn't the only station it conceived of with this excess lunar hardware. Some were designed to use Apollo hardware as it was, and add a spinning motion to create that artificial environment that astronauts would really benefit from when living and working in space. Some concepts of the late 1960s and early 1970s started to bring in the idea of using a reusable glider spacecraft with Apollo-era hardware to build this space station. There were early concept studies in the 1970s that looked at a very modular design, something where NASA could add modules to it to create a larger space station and have a spacecraft like the Space Shuttle return astronauts to the Earth and also ferry them up into their orbital platform. In the 1980s, some concept designs emerged that would see solar cells used to power the space station. One concept of a space station had a so-called roof design, which had a massive triangular feature on top with a flat roof of sorts covered in solar cells. I just put up a gallery over on Vintage Space at Popular Science showing more than 15 different concepts, artist concepts, of space stations from the 60s, 70s, and 80s. It's actually fascinating to look at the evolution of the concept of a space station over the decades, so definitely go and check that out. And be sure to come back for the next episode for more on space station freedom. So having looked at some concept art studies of early space stations, which ones are your guys' favorite that you want to know more about? Let me know in the comments below, and of course, leave your questions and comments about space stations or, of course, any other Vintage Space topic in the comments below as well. Be sure to follow me on Twitter for tons of Vintage Space content every single day of the week, and with two episodes going up right here every single week, subscribe so you never miss an episode.